Hi, I'm Gary Ruggles at Synopsys. We're at the PCI SIG DevCon in Santa Clara, and I've got a really exciting demo I want to share with you today. We're going to be looking at the world's first PCI Express 7.0 controller, and we're going to be looking at a simulation demo today. I'll describe it in detail as we go through it. As you look at this screen, you can see we've got a few windows. On the top left, we've got a window that we use to launch some of the scripts. Then as we move to this window, which I'll be starting at, I'll show you a little bit about our configuration GUI, which we call Core Consultant. It comes with the IP, allows you to set it up, and we'll show you how we set it up for Gen 7 in this demo. Then here, we'll look at some of the waveforms to kind of explain what's happening in the demo. And then finally, we'll look at the performance information, which is really critical. We want to show that this is a very high throughput, very high performance controller from Synopsys. And it's part of our complete solution that includes PHY, IDE security module, as well as verification IP. So let's dive into the demo. We'll start here. And what we're seeing is the Core Consultant GUI, the graphical user interface. On the left are a number of options here, and there's actually a lot of configurable parameters inside our controller that are controlled in this GUI. So we load up the database, we select various things, and then when we're all set and we're happy with what we have, we create the RTL. And that's what we've already done here. And the first thing you'll notice is we now have this option here of Gen 7 as the maximum speed. Typically, we would have had only Gen 6, PCI Express 6.0 at 64 gigatransfers per second, but now we have Gen 7 at 128, and that's what we're showing today. So we've already selected that, we've created the RTL, and then we have the simulators linked in to Core Consultant. So we're able to simulate and show you the results, and we've already captured that for you, so we won't have to wait for it in real time here. All right, so let's take a look at this window showing the signals in detail. So what we're doing here is capturing signals during the simulation, and particularly during the negotiation of the speed link and the bring up to L0. L0 is the normal operating mode for a PCI Express link. So what you can see looking here is we start looking at this PHY rate. It starts at zero, and the way it's mapped is zero is Gen 1, 1 is Gen 2, and so on, all the way up to this 6 being Gen 7. So we start at Gen 1, we go through a whole bunch of negotiation steps, and then we're using equalization bypass, so we're not going to Gen 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. We're going Gen 1 to Gen 7. And we come up here, and you can see that we end up at the number 6, which is Gen 7 speed. And what's happening on this line, this is the LTSSM trace. So this is showing the LTSSM state machine, starts at detect quiet, it goes through a number of steps here. I can expand like polling, et cetera, to SL0 for Gen 1, and then it gets to L0 for Gen 7. So that's the whole first step. That's an important step that gets the link established. And the next thing that we do is we send traffic through that link. We're going to do that by issuing memory writes. So let's take a look at the next window. Now this window, what we're doing is we're doing memory writes, and we're trying to show that as we do memory writes, we have a really good throughput. We're close to the theoretical maximum. So what we've got here, the lower part of the table is the most relevant one. We've got something called our RATM, our XATM here. The RATM is the receive, this is the transmit. So we're looking at both directions at the same time. This number here is the ideal throughput that you could theoretically get with a PCI Express Gen 7 link. This is a by 8 link. So if you think about it, we have 8 lanes times 128 gig, and then divide by 8 to get gigabytes. In theory, you might think you should have 128 gigabytes per second. But in fact, you've got 236 data bits in a flit out of 256. Then you've got skips and other things like that. So there's overhead, and you lose some of that bandwidth. And the actual theoretical max is just right around 116 gigabytes per second. And what we see in ours, in the PCI Express 7 controller from Synopsys, is about 115 and a half. And what we're showing here is the loss from the theoretical, and it's less, it's on the order of a half a percent. So another way to look at it is we've got about 99.5% of the theoretical maximum throughput that you can have in your link. Okay, so that was our controller demo, and this PCI 7 controller is part of our complete PCI Express 7.0 solution from Synopsys that includes controller, IDE security module, PHY, as well as verification IP. Thanks for watching.